You know already what it means when we say that some unit test is brittle. That is the unit test that will fail, either fail to compile or fail to run, when we change an unrelated detail in the underlying implementation, a detail that that test does not even mention. How do we avoid brittleness in tests, you may be thinking now? That I plan to show you in this video. I will show you a common mistake that many programmers make when they design unit tests. And then I will teach you an approach that will help you avoid that mistake. Let's begin. Here it is, a brittle test. This test is dealing with arithmetic on money. You can imagine that that is probably a very sensitive part of this application and it must be tested well. But it is brittle, as I said. And to see why it is so, we need to look at the model it is testing. There is quite a lot of logic in money subtraction here, as you can see. If the other amount is zero, whatever that means, it will not change this amount. Also, if the two amounts have the same currency and exactly the same amount, then the result of subtraction will be a proper zero. Now, what's interesting here is, if you look above, is that zero doesn't have a currency. And that is a special case in this implementation of money. If we plan to sum up multiple money amounts, we need something to start with before the first money amount comes in for summation. And that will complicate subtraction, as you can see, because if two amounts cancel each other, then the resulting amount will be zero and it will not have currency anymore. Why don't we test some of that logic? Here's the idea. I want to subtract same amount and same currency, and that subtraction must return zero money. But first, I will show you the wrong way to do that, and I will call this test brittle. The story goes like this. Take two equal amounts with the same currency, calculate their difference. There's nothing brittle here yet. But now it comes, the assertion, one of the most common sources of test brittleness. How did I know to write all this? Well, I read the implementation, so I know that it is clearing the currency, and that's how I got this assertion. But the problem is that now this test is tightly bound to the implementation, and that is the principal source of brittleness. I will now show you a different approach to asserting. What if I didn't read that code over there, the implementation? This test, which I called resilient, is supposed to be resilient to changes in the implementation, and so it's not going to be bound to the implementation, but only to the interface. Looking at the interface of the money class, I noticed that it is the record, and records have a value typed equality semantic. I would be surprised if this didn't work seriously. That would indicate a fundamental problem in how money is implemented. Well, this must be true. So let's run the unit tests and you will see that they will both pass. And that is the worst thing that can happen to you with a brittle test, to pass, because what you will do next is to commit it to source code and leave it there for the upcoming months, maybe years. Requirements will arrive, you will implement them, you will change the underlying implementation, and this test will show its brittleness on a totally unrelated event in the future. And there it comes, a few months later, the future. Customers come to us and say they have noticed a strange case. So I'm documenting the strange case. I want to reproduce the bug, you know. It will involve three values with mixed currencies. The two values will be equal. And then comes the strange part. We will subtract the first two values and they will produce a zero intermediate result. And that is setting the stage for what customer identifies as the bug. The addition will pass fine, even though The third amount has a different currency compared to the first two, and customer doesn't want different currencies to be mixed together in the same arithmetic expression. The end result of this monetary transaction is that we have started with dollars and ended up with euros. They want us to stop this operation. We invent a technical requirement that this operation, adding a mismatching currency to an intermediate zero amount in a different currency, must throw the invalid operation exception. Run the tests, and that test will fail, which means that we do have a bug and we have just reproduced it. We will implement this feature. We will make intermediate money amounts to always have a currency. That will be a dangerous change if you think about it, because money is being used all over this application. The consequence, I will tell you the consequence in advance, that brittle test will fail. For no reason. No reason at all. Before I implement this feature and the unit tests, let me ask you a favor. If you have liked this video so far, then please press the like button right now. Thank you. And if you wish to see the source code from this demonstration, there's a lot of code here, a lot of sensitive code that will need attention, then let me tell you that the code is available to sponsors of this channel, so become the sponsor. There is the link to my Patreon page in the description. Follow that link and become the sponsor. Help me keep this channel free for everyone else and get access to the source code of this video and all other videos on this channel. Thank you very much. Let's implement this feature now. I should give this test a name that is explaining that operation, but I will skip that for now. You get that already. There's a more pressing issue in code, as you see. After reading the source code, I have figured out that there are two definitions of zero money. One is zero with no known currency, and another is with the currency. These two values must be equal, and must be equal both ways. Quickly run the tests. And yes, this one is failing, so we don't have this feature in our code at the moment. I will now implement this feature. I'm not sure if you are too interested to see the implementation, so I'll do it like a dentist. I will type very fast, implement it very quickly, and that will hurt you less than if I do it slowly. Money is a record, and record is implementing component by component equivalence checks. That is not appropriate anymore, so this class will not be a record anymore. I will need to implement my own custom equivalence. The equals will treat zeros with and without currency equal. A bit of complicated logic. That's why we have tests, and that one test with equality is only one of probably half a dozen or even a dozen of tests that should test equivalence in full detail, you know. I only made one test as an example just to show you the way how to do that. I want to try my tests, and they are now passing. So, assuming that we did have the whole bunch of equivalence tests over there, those tests would pass now. But there is something else here. You see, this resilient test above, it is using the equals operator, and it didn't fail, it is still passing. I have changed the exact feature this resilient test is using and is critically dependent on, and it didn't break. Now, let's enable this test and make it pass. That will fix the bug. The problem is in how the subtract method is implemented. This is the faulty case that doesn't exist anymore. We do not create a proper zero, that one with no currency, when amounts are equal. Instead, we create a zero amount with the currency. We retain the currency from this amount when it turns into zero. the moment of truth, running the tests. Let's see. One is failing. Everyone else is passing, but one is failing. And which one is that? The brittle one. So if you look at this test run, the conclusion is that all the tests in the test suite are passing, so we did implement the feature right. We did remove the bug that we have identified. But one other test, totally unrelated to the new feature, is now failing. Let's see why. Here, it assumes that there will be no currency in the zero result. Why does it assume that? Again, because I have read that implementation that was in effect at the time when I was making this test, and that's how the implementation was working. Which means that this test had made an assumption about a concrete implementation, and that has made it brittle. Don't make assumptions about the implementation, because as the code evolves, as implementation changes over time, some of those assumptions will turn false, and then your tests will just fail. You won't be able to tell why they failed. You have changed something that really, really doesn't have anything to do with that test, but the test is red. I will just turn it off. This is not how the tests should be done. The main takeaway from this demonstration is that the other test, which is testing exactly the same kind of behavior as that brittle one, which was red, is still green. It has proven to be resilient to change in the underlying implementation. A serious, dangerous change in implementation, but even that dangerous change did not upset this test. I hope you enjoyed this demonstration and that you have learned something new about unit testing. Watch other videos on my channel, subscribe to my channel, and see you in the next episode.